Of course, the ulama, the great scholars, al-Rabbaniyun, they have divided ulama to three types. They said there is alim jumhur, wa alim sultan, wa alim rabbani. Alim jumhur, alim, his role is to, as much as he can, have a group of people. If there is a lecture and not 1,000 people turn up, he doesn't even turn up. هذا اسمه ايش؟ عالم جمهور. There is عالم سلطان. Whatever the king tell him, he stamps. He's just a rubber stamp and a stooge and a toy anyway. And there is عالم رباني who speaks the حق even if he end up in jail. Even if he end up in jail. Even if he end up in jail. طيب, who do I follow? Who do I follow? The ulama of usul al-fiqh, they said the اجتهاد of the layman is to look for the عالم رباني to the best of his ability and take his word. Is to look for the alim rabbani to the best of his ability and take his word. Is to look for the alim rabbani to the best of his ability and take his word. And the ulama warned from running after the sultan. You see alim always sitting in the gathering of the king and wiping his clothes. You know, khalas. So you need to understand sometimes you can't be so gullible. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you have the sincere iman in your heart and you ask, Allah will direct you to the right alim. He said, do we reject everything? He says, no, you take what you believe that you are prepared to face Allah with. I get asked this question all the time. As Prophet ﷺ said to the man, he said to him, Ya Rasulullah, the opinions are becoming too much. What do I do? He said, check your heart. Meaning, it's very simple formula. Am I prepared to take the opinion of this man and stand in front of Allah with this opinion? If you're not prepared, khalas, your heart told you that it is wrong. And wallahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that upon every human there is a basira. You have an insight within you that you know you're doing something wrong. You know this doesn't sound right at all. And khalas, why you implement it?